buddies, it's your girl Christina and I'm nervous. But today we're checking out Home Invasion Horror Story Animated. This is by Llama Arts. So, I imagine this is a true story of a home invasion. That means when someone just comes into your home. So I'm scared. Link for this video is in the description box below for you to check out. No long intro needed. Let's get started. Home Invasion Horror Story.
It was a cold, foggy evening when I contacted a close friend of mine to stay at my place for the
night.
You
see them trees?
Both
too many trees.
Both of us were only 10 years old at the time, and my parents were often at work until midnight, so I was usually alone with nothing to do except watching a television show or reading a book.
Oh, he's really
my
close
friend
to
Alex had agreed to come over
TV.
And brought a game of Monopoly to pass some of the time.
That's good.
I also asked if he was interested in going to explore
an abandoned
subway station 3 miles away.
What?
He seemed excited at first, so we planned to go on the trip in the morning.
I remembered that
the subway dated back to the mid-1920s and became abandoned in 1932 after the market crash in 1929.
Oh my god,
I was
like,
very
Great Depression.
Fascinated about its history, but never got the chance to go inside after my parents had warned me not to enter.
Oh my goodness.
As
you
I quietly slept
parents.
In my bed, I heard what sounded like a gunshot coming from the forest behind the house.
What?
Both of us woke up, frightened after what we had heard.
Uh-huh.
I told my friend not to worry, as hunters tend to go into the forest on frequent occasions. But when I checked the time, it was 11:39 p.m.
Yeah.
This seemed very unusual, as hunters only came into the forest between 8 p.m. and 10 p.m.
Okay, so that's a normal thing then.
I decided to get out of my bed, intending to look through the window and spot for anyone in the forest.
Okay.
The darkness clouded my vision, so I was unable to see anyone in the forest.
That's very dark.
I turned around and looked at Alex again, when suddenly I heard the front door squeak open. Chills went down my spine.
Both
of us quietly moved to the bathroom, locked the door, and kept the light off.
Yeah,
it
keep it off.
It was the only safe place in the house. Both of us were terrified as we desperately
and
tried
call
to keep
anybody.
As calm as we could.
Yeah, I didn't call anybody.
We heard footsteps getting louder and louder until they stopped in front of the bathroom door.
No.
This is when the most terrifying sound forced my heart to almost
get
burst.
Get down. Oh my goodness.
I screamed as the person chucked the door to pieces.
Oh my goodness.
It was pitch black inside the room,
making
it hard to find the vent.
And
by the
gosh.
Time I spotted the vent, the person behind the door had made a hole big enough for us to see him. The man adorned black leather and was wearing a plain doctor mask.
He knew that they were home alone.
I scurried back to the vent, but it was too high above the floor for us to reach.
Oh my gosh.
So Alex told me to go first because he was the strongest.
No.
He lifted me up on his shoulders,
allowing
me to open the vent and crawl inside.
Okay.
When I looked at the door again, the man had managed to fit his arm through the
hole
and reached for the lock. I quickly grabbed Alex's hand, but struggled to pull him up into the vent.
Okay. No!
Alex!
I shouted, and began going after him. I pursued the figure until I was led to the abandoned subway deep within the forest.
No!
It was chilly and foggy,
meaning
that I could only see objects within a range of 5 or 6 yards.
Call somebody!
Inside the subway was a pool of freezing cold water.
Oh no.
It was so dark that I couldn't see anything.
No!
I had to rely on listening to the screams from Alex and track the source.
Oh no.
As I slowly walked through the subway, I was now struggling to breathe under the intense stress and fear of the situation.
Oh goodness, and you can't see.
I called, but there was no response.
No.
I continued walking through the water until the exit was no longer visible.
No.
I was now experiencing a massive panic attack.
No.
I had lost track of Alex, and I had no idea where I was or
how to get out.
Where are you, Alex?
Oh my goodness. Was confirmed dead that he was found inside the ticket office hanging from the ceiling. His closest friend remains missing. Hold on. I've got a question here. Wait. Alex was confirmed dead after he was found inside the ticket office hanging from the ceiling. Alright, so this is a true freaking story where Alex is. So were both of the kids missing? So both of the kids are missing, but one was found. Alex was found dead but the kid himself is missing. So somebody just wrote the story of what they think their experience was. It had to be, because how would you have known the story if the kid is missing? Oh my goodness. Oh my gosh. Guys. Yo. It was 1983. Ain't no cell phones. I don't think. There were no cell phones, so they couldn't, you know, they could have called 911 using the dial thing. But the person who attacked the house knew that they, you know, goodness, they didn't even lock the door because it creaked open. They didn't have to, the person didn't have to break in unless they jimmied the lock. I don't know. This is just messed up, bro. Super freaking messed up. I hate when they're like real stories and like the person died. It's one thing if it's a crazy story and stuff happened, but everybody's alive, everybody's good. When it's a story and like it's like children died, it's like another level of feelings there. I can't. Well, let me know how it affected you down below in the comment section. Oh, goodness, this hurts my heart. If you like that video, check out the link in the description box below to support the folks over at Llama Arts. If you like this video, hug the life out of that like button. I love you guys as always. And until next time, buddies, toodles.